How's it going, film and TV fans? Welcome back to another review on the Off the Cuff Film Reviews YouTube channel and the Off the Cuff Film Reviews podcast. That's a new thing we have now. Welcome to Season 1, Episode 2, if you're wanting to know that information. And today, we are looking at a 2022 film released in September of this year. One of my favourites of this year, See How They Run, directed by Tom George, starring Sam Rockwell, Saoirse Ronan, loads of people, Adrian Brody, to name but a few. There's a few more people in this movie as well. Yeah, it's one of my favourites of this year because it's so perfectly self-aware of what it is, and it's so perfect in that regard. Other than the fact that it is essentially Wes Anderson's Knives Out, it's very heavily inspired by Wes Anderson, I think, in terms of its shots, its framing as well, for a lot of the case, I think. And also its music as well, as you can hear now, Daniel Pemberton's score is heavily inspired by that of the Wes Anderson scores by both Alexander Desplat and Mother's Bell. So, you know, that's something it has in its stride, I think. It's just perfectly, it's one of the better written films of this year because it really manages to be so self-aware of what it's talking about. There's a moment in the film where they're talking about how the writer, this character here, whose name escapes me, but there's a character who is the screenwriter for the film, that's in, not this film, but, okay, fine. In the film, basically the film was about the Mousetrap, but they have Agatha Christie novel that was a stage show and how it wanted to be turned into a film in whenever, I can't remember, it's about the 30s, I think. And the screenwriter of the Mousetrap film is having a conversation with the two inspectors, and there's an ongoing flashback between them being in a hotel suite. And the screenwriter says, "What next?" A caption that reads 2 weeks later. And then we then cut to a caption that reads 3 weeks later. It's that kind of self-awareness and funny, that kind of self-awareness that really makes the film one of the better of this year, I think. At least for me personally, I really love it. I was thinking of some other characters in this movie, you can see all the cast here. They're all great in their own right. I think Sam Rockwell and Saoirse Ronan have a fucking fantastic chemistry in this movie. And it really shows, I think, here that they definitely had that chemistry for most of the runtime. I think, hell, even all of the runtime. It wouldn't surprise me if that was genuinely how it started off, with just the two of them in the movie just going, bouncing off each other. But yeah, it's just, it's a great mix between Knives Out and Wes Anderson's style of filmmaking, I think, without it being too obvious per se. But it's got a great score, it's got really great writing. It's really not one to miss, if you ask me, in my opinion. It's just so, I like the fact it's self-aware, but it's not Deadpool self-aware or in-your-face self-aware. It's very kind of traditional self-aware per se. But I think another moment, another meta moment in the movie is where Adrian Brody's character then describes what he wants to see as an ending for the movie version of the Mousetrap, and that is what he describes essentially is exactly how this movie, See How They Run, ends, which is just like the whole self-awareness thing again. Yeah, it's a whodunit, it's a murder mystery that is pretty much told, like most murder mysteries of this type, having the character whose murder is the start of this whole thing, is shown at the beginning, and then each other person's relationship with that character, and so on and so forth. I'm not going to spoil the ending, because it's quite an interesting twist, I won't lie. And actually, when I went to see this movie, I saw this movie, I think, twice in the cinema, perhaps three times. I was going to see it the third time, but I didn't. I saw it the first time on my own, and the second time I saw it with some friends. Now, I'd seen the movie already and they hadn't, and in the entranceway, the foyer of the cinema we're at, there was a poster for this movie that had all the characters on it, and the actors and stuff like that, and I said, you know what, without knowing anything about the movie, obviously this is in the trailer, but without, you know, knowing anything, I won't say shit, just point to the character you think is the killer, who did it, point to the person you think who did it, and we'll see if you're right or wrong. And one of the two people, and one of them got it right, and that was quite interesting, and the other one didn't, so that was an interesting kind of game we sort of played, which is something you can't really do with many other films, these days, which is why it's fun to be able to do it with that. I like the setting of, I believe it's the 1920s, but don't. That's it, the 1950s. It's just such a fun... It's one of my favourite movies of the ship because it's so fun, it's so funny, it's so Wes Anderson, and he's my favourite director. So I love that kind of thing, for me personally. Yeah, it's just so much fun, per se, and I think really it fills that niche of entertaining, comedic, and also it being a directorial debut being another quite impressive one, considering we talked about one from the last one. It's another Searchlight Pictures film, so you know usually their films are quite fun and quite different and quite either, you know, like, award-worthy. I wouldn't say this is going to get nominated for too many awards, but it's not like commercial studio film either. It's this really weird balance of in the middle of not quite award, like, it's not like Academy Award winning deliberately kind of thing, and it's also not, well, Black Adam is a great example of that kind of thing. It's not like too studio and too effects heavy, and you know what I mean, it's not that kind of thing, and that's what I really like the most about it, is it manages to just keep inside that lane the whole time, having very much been inspired by the filmography of Wes Anderson and others along the line. It's great to see some quite thrilling performances as well, and there's some really, again, there's another funny moment where the two inspectors played by Saoirse Ronan and Sam Rockwell go to the hotel and they meet the guy who takes around the hotel. He's got an accent on him, and just before they go into the hotel room, that Ed Brody's character was saying, so as everyone asked him, what part of France are you from? And he responds, Belgium. And when I saw this in the cinema both times, the laughs from the crowd were fucking hilarious. And it is quite a funny line, I won't lie. It gets me every time. I quite like that line. And like I said, it's a very well-written movie. It's a very well-paced movie as well. It doesn't lose any traction for me personally, at least throughout the runtime. It manages to stick the landing for the most part and tell each character's individual connections to the main character, but to the deceased, well enough for it to stitch together. And it doesn't drop too many particularly obvious hints as to who it actually is until we get to that closer bit to towards it. Not, but it is once again quite a well put together movie, if you ask me. It definitely balances itself out towards the end, I think. And the ending, like I said, is quite funny, and how it references to the beginning, but it's very self-aware, and I like it for that reason, like I've previously mentioned, and all the characters feel fledged out once again. It just is a load of fun for me, and that's what I enjoy the most about it. I think it's very lavish, is the right word. It's very it knows itself well as well, and it takes it in its pride and uses it to its advantage, which is something I love about it. And yeah, that's my view of See How They Run. I recommend you check this movie out. At the moment, it is currently streaming on Disney Plus in the United Kingdom. I don't know whereabouts for the rest of the world, if it is or isn't yet, but I know at least the United Kingdom it is. So thanks so much for watching this review of See How They Run. Go check out the other ones. If you're listening on the podcast, big ups to you. Go continue to listen to the podcast and stuff like that. Yeah. Again, the link for the podcast version will be in the description for this review and every review going forward. So, yeah, thanks so much for watching. Have a wonderful day, or listening, if you're listening. Don't forget to check out all the other videos and check out the podcast, music releases as well. And, yeah, just enjoy the movie and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye for now.